eventually an adult.
And you kind of just suffered through it.
This is not a shot. This is a
shot in the face.
Y'all do the ill, right?
There are other ways to heal some
kind of
people.
This goes in your body and it needs to check on the body.
You had a job, so you look forward to the next day.
That was in the whole thing. That's not all I said.
You have a reason to go to sleep and wake up next morning.
Not providing medical attention.
Amen. Only God, the love of riches.
Notebook. Just how many other places like mine are there in America? In 2014, I started traveling the country trying to find out. From west to east, from today to history, I was expecting to uncover remnants of a flawed past, but instead, it felt like I was looking into a far darker future. Instead of stitching together old wounds, these lines across the map seemed more like veins just waiting to be opened. Today, I'm thinking about the places I've been to, the things I've seen, and the people I've met. My mind remains unsettled. Residents of Flint still have poisoned water. In Appalachia, the jobs have disappeared. And along the border, the suffering of immigrants has been turned into political theater, where people are looking at the same images but seeing two different things. Yet looking back today, it's too easy and too cynical to say that all is lost, that previous faith was misplaced, that truth doesn't exist, and that common ground cannot be found. I needed to understand the country and these times the only way I knew how, to go look and see. From home, I traveled south and east and crossed the Colorado. Tuesday, August 13th, 2019, Tuba City, Arizona. I talk with Jeremiah, who sells blood to make ends meet. No water, no phone, no electricity, though a set of buzzing, high-voltage wires passes just behind his house, delivering megawatts of power to Las Vegas.
They give you twice a week scheduled to get your plasma. The first out of that twice a week is $25, and the second one is $35. It's a source of income, you know. And then I use that to pay sometimes the whole water. And then for propane, stuff we need around the house.
Monday, March 13th, 2017, Uniontown, Alabama.
It's awful. It's terrible. I think we could live better than this. This about the landfill. Not only that, we got the cheese plant. It stinks. It smells like colts. Then when it's summer, you can't even sit outside. You can't barbecue. You can't enjoy your life. Flies everywhere. Your people come here for July. You can't even sit outside because the flies. When the area like you live in the county, you don't have for cell phones. Your cell phone only works a certain distance. And then you live in a property, how you going to have a cell phone? So where do the other money come from? You got to pay your burial insurance. You got to pay health insurance. There's so many things you can do with a little money, but where are the jobs? There's no jobs coming here. We got too many problems, too many issues. And some people say, if they don't want a job, how can you get a job? Where are you going to go? This is all you know. And then my little granddaughter, she has a skin disease that when she scratches, it breaks the skin. She can't even sit outside because flies going to attack her. You know what I'm saying? Flies carry germs.
Tuesday, March 21st, 2017, Demopolis, Alabama. James, at home in Hale County, tells me nothing changed. People just learned how to coexist without killing each other. And when I say kill, I mean with a gun.
There are other ways to kill somebody, you know. You can damn near starve them to death, you know. You can almost work them to death. Not provide medical attention when they need it. There are a lot of ways to kill a person.
I wanted to break free of the boundaries of place, to erase them, essentially, and be able to get to this core facet of American life. To show how connected and how close these places are in all parts of the country.
Basically, I mean, it's just me. Your mother's dead, father's dead, brother's dead. Well, it's never been a great opportunity. Basically, for as jobs go, you gotta go other places to find a job. Anything at least paying a decent $20 to $25 an hour salary, that'd be it. It's not great, but it's what you're used to. There's a lot of things wrong, but hey, what can you do? Sit back, worry about it, die, or keep going.
Sunday, March 8th, 2020, Detroit, Michigan. Detroit by car. Whispers of a coming wilderness. Through Pole Town, East Village, Old Redford, flocks of pheasants grazing in the empty lots. I'm told a pack of coyotes is on the loose, and there's rumors of mountain lions. Deepening potholes announce the arrival of spring. On the radio, a virus is spreading. Monday, January 18th, 2019, Unionville, Maine. Grace is 83 years old and lives alone in a gray shingled house perched atop a small knoll bisected by a steep drive. An ancient wood stove is barely visible beneath a heap of old fabric and sewing materials. Six boxes of cereal sit unopened on top of an old Sears and Roebuck fridge. Her community, Unionville, is on the map, but doesn't really exist anymore. You could look down the road and see eight houses between here and the railroad track. Now there's nothing there at all, she tells me. Tuesday, December 20th, 2016, Cherry Creek, South Dakota. Cherry Creek is about 80 houses, 4 churches, 3 cemeteries, and a tire shop nestled at the bottom of a big, broad valley. Welcome to Crack Creek, a man tells
People
me.
People think that Cherry Creek's a bad place, but that was a long time ago, you know. Me and all my brothers now, we're all grown up.
The food pantry has no sign, as if everyone who needs to know already knows where it is.
Most people depend on the government now. When you barely take that food stamp card away, they get scared. How are we gonna eat? How are we gonna live, you know? If we had a job, something to look forward to the next day, something to get up and have a reason to go to sleep and wake up the next morning, I gotta get to bed so I can go to work.
I park outside the church and sleep in the van. In the night, I turn it on and let it run. The heat coming up from the exhaust pipe, keeping the inside warm.
I kind of fell off the wagon again and started drinking. And then one morning I got up and my kids were up and they were hungry. And I had no food. And so right then and there, I decided I'm gonna sober up now. You know, my kids need money to buy food more than I need this alcohol. And I started crying, and ever since then, I've been sober. I mean, there's hope, but it's just not a lot.
The difference in life expectancy between America's richest places and its poorest is 20 years. These are some of the hardest working areas of the country. But in places where unpaid bills and broken headlights can mean jail, there's no getting ahead. As people say, it's expensive to be poor. Friday, November 13th, 2020, Exeter, California. Fall. Through farm fields north and west of home. The sky is overcast, the color of ashtrays. Leaves still cling to trees, but just. Bright red pomegranates hang like Christmas ornaments from yellowed trees. Big tubes of harvested cotton are being hauled off the fields on flatbed trucks. On Cam Avenue, between Kingsburg and San Joaquin, a loaded down alfalfa truck leaves a straw rain in its wake that dances off my windshield for a quarter mile. I pass the harvested vineyards, the grape canopies between red and brown, the color of dried blood. Everything feels exhausted, both the land and me.